A very good morning to all of you. I am Dr. Neetu Gailor from St. Andrews Institute of Technology and Management. I am the chemistry faculty here. Today, my topic are water chemistry. So here are the some subtopics also here. First of all, these subtopics are the introduction of water, next the sources of water, then impurities of water, and then hardness of water. Hardness of water is the most important topic of this lecture. And the last is the hardness is expressed in the terms of calcium carbonate reason. So now I will start our first topic, that is introduction of water. As we know that after air, water is a most common, important and useful compound of all living organisms. Without water, we cannot survive. Do you know that our body contains 70 to 75% of water, which regulates life process such as digestion, such as transportation of nutrients, such as excretion of body waste, etc. And water is the most important participant of photosynthesis reaction. Then, this is a small introduction of water. Next topic is sources of water. We know that water is found in free state, as in the ice form, in water form, or in the water vapors form. And the water is very poor conductor of heat and electricity. We know that water is the universal solvent. That's why it is widely used in the laboratories, industrial purpose, irrigation, air conditioning, steam generator, etc. And our daily life functions, just like the drinking, bathing, sanitary, etc. The sources of water. In the sources of water, here is a chart. Or at the screen of, there is a chart for the sources of water. So, first is the rainwater. Second, surface water, and the last is the underground water. We all know about the rainwater. The second part is the surface water. Surface water means there are the surface water is divided into the three parts. First is the rainwater, lake water, and the sea water also. And the underground water is divided as well water and the spring water also. So this is the sources of water. A small chart of the sources of water. Next topic is impurities of water. There are so many impurities which are present in the water. Here I discussed some impurities here. There are the following impurities which have been found as common present in water. The three impurities are present. First one is the dissolved impurities, second is the suspended impurities, and the third part of is the harmful microorganisms. So, firstly, I discuss the dissolved impurities. Dissolved impurities means that water may contain soluble, organic, and inorganic, and gaseous, etc. So, the inorganic impurities here, organic impurities here, and the gaseous impurities here. So, first of all, these are the inorganic impurities. Yeah, inorganic salts. So these are usually bicarbonates, chlorides, nitrates, sulfate of sodium, magnesium, potassium, calcium, aluminium, zinc, etc. So these are the inorganic salts present in the water and impure our water. And the second is organic salts. Organic means the, normally we can say that is the dead or decay material of the animals and the plants or the waste material also. Yeah. So organic salts means these are generally soluble organic compounds obtained by the domestic sewage, industrial wastes, or decay of dead animals or plants, etc. These are the organic impurity. Now, the gaseous form. Gaseous forms is the gases are present in the water. These are just like oxygen, carbon dioxide, hydrogen sulfide, which release from the industries, so they pollute the water. So now we discussed the gaseous form. From industries, several gases like oxygen, carbon dioxide, hydrogen sulfide, ammonia, oxides of nitrogen, oxides of sulfur dioxide, etc. These are the gaseous impurities, and these gases are responsible for the corrosion. I repeat, these gases are responsible for the corrosion also. And the corrosion topic we will discuss in the next topic, next lecture. The second type of impurities are the suspended impurities. Suspended matlab ki jo latka hua hai beech mein. These are the suspended impurities. So the sand, clay, lime, etc., which are present in water, get suspended. Latke rehte hain. The heavy particles settle down after standing sometimes, while the smaller particles remains in the water as colloidal particles. So these are the suspended particles. And the third type of impurity is harmful microorganisms. Harmful microorganism is ki there are so many pathogenic microorganisms, just like bacteria, fungus, and viruses, etc. So the various pathogenic microorganisms like bacteria, fungus, viruses, etc., also enter in water through waste and sewage. So these are causes of so many diseases. So it is the impurities of water portion. The next topic and the most important topic is hardness. Hardness, what do you mean by the hardness? What is hardness? Kya hota hai hardness? Hardness means it is the character of water, or we can say that hardness is the property of water which resists the lather formation with soap. Repeat again. Hardness is the property of water which resists the lather formation with the soap. यानी जब हम पानी को साबुन के साथ रिएक्ट कराएंगे तो वहां पे झाग बनेंगे. ओके, तो पानी की दैट प्रॉपर्टी ऑफ वाटर विच रेजिस्ट द लेदर फॉर्मेशन, जो उसको झाग को बनने से रोक रहा है, दिस इज हार्डनेस. तो मेन द डेफिनेशन ऑफ हार्डनेस इज इट इज द प्रॉपर्टी ऑफ वाटर विच रेजिस्ट द लेदर फॉर्मेशन विथ सोप. हियर वन मोर क्वेश्चन इज what is soap? So soap can be defined. Soap means soaps are the higher fatty acids of sodium or potassium salt. And now here the word is higher fatty acids. Fatty acids, the example of fatty acids is a stearic acid. Stearic acid, the formula of stearic acid is the C17H35COOH. C17H35COOH is a stearic acid, and here we use the sodium or potassium salt of stearic acid. So the formula will be C17H35COONa or K, sodium or potassium. So this is the hardness. So when soap come in contact with water, we can say that when soap comes in the contact with hard water, the calcium ion and the magnesium ion, which are already present in water, they combine with the soap and form insoluble sticky precipitate. That's why hard water does not produce lather with the soap. It is a hardness. Okay. So the next question is, what are the causes of hardness? Causes of hardness. Causes of hardness means if the calcium or magnesium ions are present in the water, it means there is the hard water. And it is due to the presence of the sulfate, chloride, and bicarbonate of calcium or magnesium salt. So reason for the hardness, the main reason of the hardness are the presence of calcium or magnesium salts. Next, the types of hardness. In short, here we have discussed types of hardness. So types of hardness means there are two types of hardness. simply we can divide the hardness into two types. One is the temporary hardness and the second is the permanent hardness. So temporary hardness means it is due to the presence of bicarbonate of calcium or magnesium. It can be removed by the simple boiling process. So that temporary hardness means the hardness which can be removed by the simple boiling method is temporary hardness. Or temporary hardness due to the presence of bicarbonate of calcium or magnesium ions. So it is temporary hardness. The another is the permanent hardness. Permanent hardness means it is due to the presence of sulfate and chloride of calcium and magnesium. Means if sulfate and chloride of calcium or magnesium are present in the water, so it means it is a permanent hardness. It is a permanent hardness, and permanent hardness can't be removed by the simple boiling method. We can't remove the permanent hardness by the simple boiling method, but we can remove the temporary hardness by the simple boiling method. Then, what is the difference between the temporary hardness and the permanent hardness? Temporary hardness due to the presence of bicarbonate of calcium and magnesium, and the permanent hardness, it is due to the presence of sulfate and chloride of calcium or magnesium. Okay, and the second difference, we can remove the temporary hardness by simple boiling method, and permanent hardness, we can't remove the permanent hardness by the simple boiling process. So it is a major difference between the temporary hardness and the permanent hardness. Okay, then, but nowadays the temporary and the permanent hardness is replaced by the alkaline or non-alkaline hardness. Temporary hardness or permanent hardness is replaced by the alkaline and non-alkaline hardness. So what is alkaline hardness? Alkaline hardness, the another name of alkaline hardness is the carbonate hardness. Carbonate hardness means when hardness of water is due to the presence of bicarbonate, carbonate and hydroxide. When the hardness of water is due to the presence of bicarbonate, carbonate and hydroxide, means bicarbonate means HCO3, carbonate means CO3, hydroxide means OH. Okay, so if the presence of bicarbonate, carbonate and hydroxide of the calcium and magnesium, then it is called the alkaline hardness, or we can say it is the carbonate hardness also. And non-alkaline hardness, another name is non-carbonate hardness. Non-alkaline hardness is determined as the subtracting of the alkaline hardness from the total hardness. Such type of hardness is due to the presence of sulfate, chloride, etc. of calcium and magnesium. Okay, so same thing is here. So don't be confused into the carbonate hardness or non-carbonate hardness or the permanent hardness or the temporary hardness. Okay, so this is the main types of hardness is the temporary and the permanent hardness. It is very important that what is the difference between the temporary and the permanent hardness. Very important question. Now we discuss the hardness is expressed in the terms of calcium carbonate. We express the hardness in the terms of calcium carbonate. But why? Reason bhi hote hai. So there are the two main reasons. So that hardness is expressed in the terms of calcium carbonate. The first reason is calcium carbonate is completely insoluble salt. Thus, it can be easily precipitated completely during water treatment. I repeat, calcium carbonate is completely insoluble in water. Thus, it can be easily precipitated completely during water treatment. The first reason is the calcium carbonate is completely insoluble in water. And the second part is the molecule. If we calculate the molecular weight of calcium carbonate, you can calculate the molecular weight of calcium carbonate and it is exactly 100. So the molecular weight of calcium carbonate is 100. so that the mathematical calculation become easy. It is very old convention that, and the fact is not so. So these are, there are the two main reason for hardness expressed in the terms of calcium carbonate. The and equivalent of calcium carbonate. So how can we calculate the equivalent of calcium carbonate? We all know that the molecular weight of calcium carbonate, yeah, if we calculate the molecular weight of calcium carbonate is 100 and the equivalent weight, equivalent mass of calcium carbonate is 50. So the formula equivalent of the calcium carbonate is equal to amount of substance causing hardness in milligram per liter, and it's multiply with the equivalent mass of calcium carbonate and divided by the equivalent mass of hardness producing substance. Here we can represent the mass of substance causing hardness by the capital W, equivalent mass of hardness producing substance by the capital E. So that then equivalent of calcium carbonate is equal to W into 50 upon E. W means the mass of substance causing hardness, and capital E means that is the equivalent mass of hardness producing substance. And what 50 is the equivalent mass of calcium carbonate. Okay, so it is the method by which we can calculate the equivalent of calcium carbonate, which is used in the numericals also. So now I repeat again those topics which are discussing in this video. First of all, we will discuss the simple introduction of water. Then I discuss the sources of water. After that, there are some impurities which I've already discussed. The inorganic impurities, organic impurities, gaseous impurities, suspended impurities, some harmful pathogenic impurities, microorganisms also. So next is the important topic of hardness, the definition of hardness, the types of hardness, the temporary hardness, the permanent hardness, the reasons for the temporary and the permanent hardness, and how can we remove the temporary and the permanent hardness. These are the today's topics. At the last, I discussed the hardness is expressed in the terms of calcium carbonate. It is the important topic of this video. Okay, hardness is expressed in the terms of calcium carbonate, and the two main things are there. Okay, first of all, calcium carbonate is completely insoluble salt, thus it can be easily precipitated. And the second part is the molecular weight of calcium carbonate is 100. We can calculate it. And so the mathematical equation becomes easy, and we want to the equivalent mass of calcium carbonate, that is 50. So we can calculate the equivalent mass of 50, and after that, according to our numerical problem, there is that we can calculate the equivalent mass of calcium carbonate. So I repeat, the equivalent mass of calcium carbonate is equal to W into 50 upon E, where W is the mass of substance causing hardness, and the capital E is the equivalent mass of hardness producing substance. So at the end of my audio, here I have two main questions for you. First question is, why we use calcium carbonate in the terms of hardness of water? I repeat my first question, why we use calcium carbonate to express the hardness of water? And my second question, what do you understand by the alkaline and non-alkaline hardness? Okay. Two questions are here. First, why we use calcium carbonate to express the hardness of water? And the second question is, what do you understand by the alkaline and non-alkaline hardness? So these are the two questions. Now, at the ending of my audio, and if you have any doubt which is related to these topics, so first of all, you can refer to my notes. And also you can discuss with me. Okay, thank you so much.